And here we are hopping right into team preview. So we have on Erika's side team two possible Megas, very likely Megas, and Salamence and Kangaskhan, because when is it not a Mega? And of course, on the east side, possible Megas and Gardevoir, very likely, and possibly one in Tyranitar as well. Maybe a dual Mega team. Maybe not. So, some interesting lead possibilities here. Erika looks like she's running a more high offense team, likely as a Kangaskhan in lead, with that Melodic to deter possible Intimidates. Its competitive ability giving it a big boost if someone tries to use an Intimidate to lower its partner Kangaskhan attack.
So Lewis will have to be careful where he places that Landorus in his team if he decides to bring it.
Yeah, he might be keeping the back. I mean, a Landorus out in the front with the Melodic, unless... But he has other ways of deterring. Of course, that Thundurus, the Moogus, all are pretty good deterrents to Kangaskhan. Maybe not so much against the Salamence, but even Thundurus can give Salamence a hard time there. So I actually... Thundurus can affect a lot of things. I expect Lewis to bring it this round.
All right, so our players have jumped right into the match, chosen their four Pokemon, so let's see what leads they send out. Erika has decided on Kangaskhan and Milotic, while Lewis, on the bottom of your screen, send out Gardevoir and Thundurus.
Ooh, okay. Lewis smartly not going in with the Intimidate after all, and as we predicted, the Melodic is there to try to protect his friend Kangaskhan from the Intimidates, but not today. So, and it looks like probably a fake out, maybe on Gardevoir or Thundurus. Thundurus doesn't usually carry Protect, so that's usually the prime choice for a fake out there. But that might give Gardevoir an opportunity to attack if Luis decides to predict and go with a bold prediction and attack right away instead of protecting against the fake out.
Thundurus could disrupt either Kangaskhan or Melodic if it decides to use Thunder Wave. Both players have selected our moves, so Erika's going to start off right away by evolving her Mega Kangaskhan. In a sense, waiting. There's no ghosts in the back to use Scrappy ability if that's what it has.
That's of course,
more than likely.
So, and no switches from either side here. Given the more offensive nature of Erika's team, she already has the offense she has on her team out right now. If she switched to try to get into better position, actually, I don't see what kind of better position she could get into. Mm-hmm. There we go. The fake out going out in Thundurus.
Gardevoir predicted itself, and Melodic goes out with an icy wind that's going to lower the speed of the Thundurus and maybe pave the way for a little bit faster paced match.
And Luis playing it safe with the Gardevoir, not wanting to lose it too early, but probably missing out on an opportunity to get some good Hyper Voice damage on the Melodic Kangaskhan. Other than that, okay. Luis decides to protect Gardevoir even further, saving it for later in the battle. We got Tyranitar. It's probably expecting a double-edged return from that Kangaskhan.
That's also going to set up a Sandstorm and boost Tyranitar's special defense. Thundurus uses Thunder Wave on Kangaskhan. Going to hope for some paralysis and at least lower its speed as well.
Oh, definitely. It's much easier to manage that way.
Kangaskhan does get off the return on Tyranitar. It doesn't do very much damage, about 25%. As Melodic uses Icy Wind again to lower the speed so that Thundurus is slowing down, other than its support type moves.
Yeah,
and Tyranitar's speed is dropped as well.
Fortunately, because of Prankster, Icy Wind speed drop does nothing to stop its priority boosted Thunder Waves here.
We've seen the move on Thundurus too, as it heals back health with Citrus Berry, and it's less than 50% now, and that Sandstorm's also going to chip away some damage at all the Pokemon on the field other than Tyranitar.
A little, but I don't think it's going to be the big damage decider this battle here. Tyranitar, okay, thanks on going for Sucker Punch, expecting an attack from Thundurus. Very interesting.
Mm-hmm. And it's so close at 18 HP left. Tyranitar uses a low kick on Kangaskhan, does a massive amount of damage, but not enough to knock it out, as Melodic reveals the Scald on Tyranitar. hopefully getting the burn, but oh, there it is.
There is the burn. Poor Tyranitar here, but it does. But Melodic. Okay. Recover is up to 60% health from the Citrus Berry. Fortunately, I don't think Thunderous is going to get another chance to attack here unless it uses a Thunder Wave here. In which case, Melodic can smartly protect. In this case, Luis's own Sandstorm was kind of working against him, giving Thunderous one less turn to work in the battle. But it does, the fact that Thunderous is going to Faint next turn gives him a free switch in. In fact, actually, both Tyranitar and Thunderous will switch, are going to go down to burn and Sandstorm, respectively. So he gets two free switch-ins to healthy Pokemon back without taking damage. Unfortunately, that puts him in a 2-4 situation, but he actually might be able to recover from that with Paralyzed Melodic, a weakened, and a weakened Kangaskhan here.
Kangaskhan gets the Sucker Punch off on Tyranitar, so it doesn't get any last move in, but we're going to see that Thunderous go down to Sandstorm damage, or in this case, Melodic's Icy Wind. So I'm wondering what other moves that Melodic's carrying, if that was its moves of choice. Probably a safe call in case the Tyranitar didn't attack.
It may have had Recover, but it couldn't take the chance that Thunderous is going to try and attack again. So Erika's playing it safe here. And also, still in a good 4-2 position, she has a lot of maneuverability to switch out if she wants to, but it's probably her better bet to try and let Kangaskhan faint on its own.
Yeah, it's hanging on for dear life, has one turn left.
Now,
this is interesting. So Landorus was in the back. That Intimidate raises Melodic's special attack by 2 stages. So with a good amount of health, it could do an interesting amount of damage to that Gardevoir or Landorus, whatever it decides
Maybe.
To do.
Maybe, but I don't think Luis, in order for Luis to win here, he can't let Melodic get an attack off here.
Unfortunately, the Kangaskhan is paralyzed. Finally, that Thunder Wave coming into play, and Gardevoir attacking that Melodic. It does hang on, and its special defense is dropped.
For another competitive boost that it's probably not going to get a chance to use, unless Rock Slide. No, Rock Slide didn't miss here.
And unfortunate. I'd like to see that Melodic take something down with a +4 attack. So both Pokemon go down on Erika's side.
Interesting to note here, that Landorus is not holding a Choice Scarf. Otherwise, it would be faster than its partner Gardevoir here. So likely
Assault Vest?
Probably Assault Vest. Could be a Choice Band. If it's Assault Vest, then Luis has the ability to switch the moves around here. And here, bringing Terrakion and Salamence, two juicy targets for a Pixelate, very tight Hyper Voice here. That's assuming, but Erika still could double target the Gardevoir here, take it out right away. The Landers, weakened by Intimidate, of course, may not be able to stop Salamence and Terrakion before they can take out Gardevoir. So Luis is in a tough spot here. If that Salamence Mega Evolves and becomes faster than Gardevoir, be on the losing end here. No, it's...
Oh, no. Salamence reveals a Hydro Pump, and it misses the Landorus. Terrakion gets a Rock Slide off on both Pokemon. Critical hit on the Gardevoir. Going to hope for a flinch, but not on Gardevoir. Returning with a super effective Hyper Voice. Terrakion just hanging on with about 20% HP, and the Salamence is knocked out. Landorus with the Super Power, and that is game. So, really... Really important turn.
Really. So Luis comes out in the end. And of course, I forgot, because Kangaskhan Mega Evolved earlier. There's no way that Salamence is going to Mega Evolve at all. But
all right.
I just assume every Pokemon can Mega Evolve no matter what, somehow. Just magic. But yeah, Luis comes out, takes a 2-4 situation, turns it around, right next turn.